just want to be able to go out and have a nice night for once. Is that too much to ask?
One thing I fuck up in the last 9 years. Yes, 8 years in a row.
It's literally one of the most important things you have to remember in a relationship.
That's not the right way to
speak to me. I know the difference between literal and figurative language.
Get something on me and you never let it go. Oh, come on, I knew it was your birthday.
Because you saw it on Facebook.
But that's how most people remember birthdays.
I just want a little bit of respect, Dave.
Why does everything have to be an argument?
Why do you think?
Well, you're the one raising your voice.
Because it's the only way I can be heard. You're like a child.
I'm like a child.
Yeah, you're like a child.
You're the one shouting at me. You start shouting first. I knew this was coming. There's a version of this. There's a version of this, but we've had a really lovely time.
Oh, is it?
Maybe that would
be a nice thing to do.
Put me on the bike. Just because Stevie cooks one meal doesn't mean suddenly we all have to know how to wash rice.
What are you fucking talking
about,
Dave?
It's a different thing.
It's not. Oh my God, it's about being a fucking grown-up.
I am being grown-up. How long have we been? Too much stuff going on with the band, alright? I couldn't get tied down.
Miss Carl,
Miss Caroline that she can go and suck a bag of dicks.
Dave! Teddy McGiggles says to sing the bad word song when you hear a grown-up say a bad word. Do you want to hear it?
No.
Bad word, because you said a bad thing.
Well, now we all have to sing.
Cha-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Would ever go on about was having kids, okay? That's why we fought all the time.
Hey, there are plenty of things to be scared of in this world, but having a kid isn't one of them.
They came out of a test tube.
Yeah, I know you did, Felix.
Dave, there's nothing that says you have to end up like that.
Felix, could you please tell your mom that I'm now going to go down to Domino's and get myself a proper cheese-covered pizza with a side of gluten?
Mommy, Uncle David.
You don't have to say it, Felix. Your uncle isn't making good choices right now.
You know, when you get yourself a pair of big boy pants, you realize there's more to life than tractors.
Uncle David's so serious, isn't he, Mommy?
Yes, my little fluffy ducky is.
Quack.
So, do you remember where we're up to?
Where they got away from the witches.
That's right, they're in Norway. They're safe in Grandma's house. She was wearing a lace dress, and the lace kept tickling my nose. I had to rest my head on my front paws. Have you ever heard my heart humming away, Grandmama? I asked her. Often, she said. I hear it when you're lying very close to me on the pillow at night. The two of us remained silent in front of the fire for a long time after that, thinking about these wonderful things. My darling, she said at last, are you sure you don't mind being a mouse for the rest of your life? I don't mind at all, I said. It doesn't matter who you are or what you look like, as long as somebody loves you.
Felix, get up! Felix, get up! I need your help! So, when you see her, breathe as Darth Vader, and then you say, do it properly, Felix. The mask is on your remaining character.
Hello, Monkey Sarah. I am Darth Vader. May the Force be with us.
Because Daniel Day-Lewis just came and we're wearing his pants. Okay, now, can you hold up a sign? I'll come in and take care of the rest.
Yes, Uncle David. I mean, yes, Uncle David.
All right. Do it, Darth.
Don't ever
never expect to see me back here again. Felix.
I'm not Felix, I'm Darth Vader.
Darth Vader, now! Sex with a real estate agent.
Hang on, what?
I know.
You woke my son up so that he could go and see two people having sex.
I know specifically.
A naked man punched Uncle Dave in the nose because Auntie Sarah has a slutty vagina.
I don't believe this.
No, it's unbelievable. I mean, how could you do this to me?
If you can't understand how incredibly inappropriate it is to take your nephew out in the middle of the night, then you can find somewhere else to stay.
What are you talking about? He had a great time. Look, he's Darth Vader.
I'm your father, Mummy.
So he's really good at it.
It's late. I have a double shift tomorrow. Get out of my house. Are you crying now?
Mummy, you said it's good to cry. Why can't Uncle David stay on the couch?
If you're gonna stay here, then you have to start contributing. Put him to bed now, and you can take him to school tomorrow.
Can we play the shooting game, Uncle David?
I don't want to scare in trouble, Felix. I'll have to play with the sound off.
We need to get to class early for Mr. Irwin. It's my turn to feed Neville.
Neville's special needs.
Neville's the class guinea pig.
Hey, Felix, what's for lunch today?
That's Max and Ashton. I think I'm not strong because of what Mummy packed me for food.
What fucking douchebags? Max looks like he could use a few more tofu pizzas. Max was a fat one, yeah?
What's a douchebag?
It's a small bag chicks use to irrigate their vaginas.
Oh, hi, Pico! Join me broccoli today, Felix!
Who's that retarded kid using irony to make fun of you?
We can have spina bifida.
Hi, Felix.
In the playground, huh?
Beth is my girlfriend.
Yeah, dog. Treat him mean, keep him keen.
David, you can call me Audrey.
Didn't think I was going to make it in time for pickup. That's crazy rehearsal.
I'm afraid he had a really rough day today.
Could he?
Felix.
Well, it's a good thing my band's finished rehearsing for the day. It's my band.
God's Sledgehammer.
That's right.
Is that a Christian band?
No. It's more of a stadium rock / death metal band.
Because Christian, so...
It is a Christian band. I'm a Christian myself, actually.
Oh, Sean. Beth's older brother is really sick. Oh, no, it's gastro, but I'm afraid I won't be able to chaperone the excursion tomorrow.
Of course.
I thought my class is off sick with gastro as well.
I hope I'm not leaving you in the lurch. Do you think you'd be able to find someone else?
Hey, that's me. I'm someone else. Where are we coming, Miss Caroline?
Oh, the force isn't working.
Okay, so we take it out of this. Then you take the blue safety cap off, and you push the other end in here. So it's blue in the sky, orange in the thigh.
Orange in the thigh.
Yeah, I'm serious. Blue in the sky.
Orange in the thigh. I've got it. Don't worry, we'll be fine. Just looking forward to spending some quality time with my little Lord Vader.
Can I bring this tomorrow, Uncle David?
And that's the only reason why you want to go on this excursion tomorrow.
What other reason would there be?
The one that teaches his kidney class.
Miss Caroline, come on.
Every dad is trying to make her pass it.
Well, she's a Christian. I'm in a stadium rock / death metal band. How's that going to work?
Mommy, I nearly had it.
I'm just trying to understand why you would so readily volunteer for something that sounds like your worst nightmare.
Maybe it's because I'm actually a good person. God, is that such a crazy idea?
Yeah. fixed. Next stop, Pleasant Valley.
Give Miss Caroline a cuddle.
I bet you do, Frogsy. What do you guys say we do the McGiggle?
of use ignoring all our giggling and guffawing as we shower the whole world with fun. Time and time again, we will make giggle with you, friends, because our giggles are for everyone!
Can we do the McGiggle dance?
You bet we can, Froggy! Some giggles, I'll giggle with you. Let's giggle!
We'll giggle all together.
Feel giggly when we all play this song.
Stop the
writer's block. I don't know how to explain what I'm seeing.
Are you serious?
Come here, you pretty little chubby princess. I'm gonna bash this on your head, you fat fucking monkey.
You're a fucking psycho.
Get away from that door, boy.
Upside down, and so help me God, I am going to drag you out by the
much the truth. You are part. Do I make myself clear? Let me hear you say it's a game, so I think and hear.
It's a game.
In the voice, you want.
It's a game! This is a game!
Do the laugh.
I don't want it.
The laugh.
Go!
Stop fucking swearing. You can consider this the naughty corner.
You okay?
Cover up, man. Cover up.
What did you eat, Felix? Something like...
No, they're just chips.
They'd have dairy in them.
Who the fuck wants milk and chips?
Bag. The dreny penny was in my bum bag.
I've got one. I can do it.
Okay, kids. Don't worry. Felix just needs some room, okay?
Here we go. Orange in the sky, blue in the sun. No, it's fine.
No, you can't reinsert it.
There's a spare. Just like the spare.
Where is it?
It's in his backpack.
Okay, kids.
No, I'm right here, Bert. I'm right here.
Listen very carefully. I need you to stay here with David. Hold hands. And don't let go until I get back, okay?
You'll be all right.
I'll just pop right up and let them know, okay?
Breathe. You're right. You'll be all right. Here we go. Breathe again. yes. Quick. Is that it? Here we go. Well, here we go. Here we go. Yes. Did it work?
It's my job. And you've got to call me Audrey.
Oh, I got caught in the middle of a jam fight. I'm covered in strawberry jam. Don't taste it, okay? Felix will be fine.
Thank you. Shelton. Aerial reconnaissance confirms all of the infected are congregated here. I would advise drop the bomb on the Pleasant Valley souvenir store.
How did you know the room I'm good at?
used to sing it to me before I went to sleep. Back when I was boo-boo.
Boo-boo.
Yeah. You want to get some rest, mate? Sorry, I've been swearing so much, Audrey.
That's fine, David. I'm fucking dare if I do. I just need them to feel like the adults are in control, you know?
How do you do it?
Do what?
Be a superhero.
Not quite. Do you want kids?
My girlfriend and I just split. Yeah, I caught up with someone else.
Oh, that's awful.
See, it wasn't her fault. I left first. She wanted a baby, I didn't want one.
How come?
I told her I didn't want it to get in the way of my band.
Was that not the reason?
Felix's mum reckons I might be frightened of being a father. See, her dad left me when I was about Felix's age. Started another family, left Tessina with mum. Mum fell apart, like, really fell apart. We spent our holidays in psych wards.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah. Tess looked after me. I didn't see that at the time, though. I was too angry at everyone. I never thanked her.
I'm sure you won't end up like your father, David. The man in between waits between the two, not hearing the lie, not seeing the true, unknowing what is and denying what seems. And there he will sleep, the man in between.
Is that Gandhi?
No, Neil Diamond.
You like Neil Diamond?
I love Neil Diamond. You may think I'm a superhero, but when I was 18, I was heading down a really bad path. I started following this band around. I used the money my parents had put away for my education, and I followed them here. I chased them all around Australia, and I break into one of their hotel rooms in Perth. I was just so determined to meet one of them in person. I would have let them do anything to me.
What happened?
Taylor walked into the room and called security right away.
Hang on, wait. Swift?
No. Taylor Hansen. Sorry, I thought I said who they were.
Taylor Hansen?
Yeah. Taylor Hansen, from Hansen.
Hansen, the band?
Yes.
Mbop.
Mbop.
Okay.
I begged him not to call security, but he didn't even hesitate. I didn't know what to do, so I jumped out the window.
Shit.
But thank God, an awning broke my fall, and all I broke was my collarbone. So, there I was. In a foreign country, in a sling, no parents, no money, and then a wonderful thing happened. I got a job helping out at the school to help pay my medical bills and get back home, and working with kids, standing in front of them, looking at me, no judgment. They trusted me even when I didn't particularly trust myself.
have kids?
I'm afraid Ian and I have not been together for a long time. He was cheating on me with someone from his work.
What is the weathering?
Stops fathers from hitting on me in the playground. I know it's bad to lie, but you'd be surprised how crude men can be.
My band broke up 6 years ago. God's sledgehammer fell apart when my bandmates quit. And I'm not really Christian.
Anything else you lied about?
No, I think that pretty much covers it.
Okay, good. Otherwise, I'd have to put you in the naughty corner. Why don't I stay up on watch?
No, no. You need to sleep more than anyone. I'll step up.
Operation Hailstorm at T minus 1 hour.
Then I know it's growing strong. was in the spring. Then spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along?
Get off! Oh God, what have I done? What is it, Ben?
Feel
told you you were the bravest person I'd ever met. Yeah.
The clutch is on the left.
The clutch is on the left. So you carry it, don't
you? The clutch is on the left.
Protocol, sir.
All right, let him through.
Little ducks came back.
Hey, it's music.
You're harmless when you play music.
Ah! sing him a song! Sing him a song!
Open fire!
Caroline and David
Anderson.
That's my brother. That's Felix's uncle.
Well, Miss Caroline and Mr. Anderson managed to protect your children in a potentially lethal situation for which there is no precedent. I'm still not quite sure how they did it. They're currently in quarantine, and we will need to monitor them for the next 48 hours.
They're okay? They must be terrified.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about that.
Thank you.
Thank you.